Welcome back to GMA, live from Times Square.
And now let's look at the new West Side Story. The movie and the young woman playing Maria are both getting rave reviews. We're so happy to have her with us this morning, Rachel Zegler. Welcome to GMA.
Hi, thanks for having me.
Wait, talk about starting your career with a bang. This is your first movie. Your first director is Steven Spielberg. The movie is West Side Story. You walk the red carpet. What does that feel like?
It's a whirlwind. It's also baptism by fire, but in the best way. Yeah. I mean, I can't believe that we made this movie 2.5 years ago, before the world kind of shut down in such a crazy way, and I think there's no better time for it to be releasing into theaters.
Yeah, and we can't agree with you more with that. And tell us how you got this role. You beat out 30,000 other people.
Yeah,
to be Maria.
Or so they say, right? It's wild. I reacted to an online Twitter casting call from our incredible casting director, Cindy Tolan, and I sent in what I perceive to be the worst self-tape one could possibly send in. Now that I hope it never resurfaces on the internet. I'm sure it will, and it'll be a terrible day for me online. But, it was a year-long audition process. I went in about 8 or 9 times over the course of 340-something days. And it finally came to that point where Steven looked at me and said, I want you to be my Maria, and the rest is history.
Wow. I can't even imagine what that moment was like. You were still in high school when you got the news that you got the role, but I understand you then asked Steven Spielberg, hey, is it okay if I still do my musical in high school? Can I do both?
That was one of the first things out of my mouth is, can I still do Shrek the musical at my high school? And he looked at me and he was like, I produced the original Shrek. Of course you can do Shrek the musical at your high school. And I did. And they actually altered the rehearsal schedule around for me. So I was able to do it, which was amazing. Oh, there's a video. Wow.
There's always a video.
Oh, wow.
So now you have Steven Spielberg in your phone under what, creative sponsor?
Creative sponsor. Yeah.
How often do you text Steven Spielberg?
All the time. Oh my gosh. Whenever anything exciting happens, whether it be in film or the broader musical circuit, he's the first person I go to. We talk about so much. And with the time we spent, thank you so much. With the time that we spent together on this film, there was just so many awesome conversations about our favorite movies and our favorite musicals. And there's no one who loves West Side Story more, so we would just chat. And he used to send me all of these old films to watch, all of Carol Lombard's movies. And it was just, he's such a wonderful friend and mentor to me.
That's fantastic.
Yeah.
Yeah, and we know the great Stephen Sondheim. He wrote all of the lyrics for West Side Story. He passed away just last week, but he was there at all the recording sessions.
He was.
So what was it like to work with him?
An incredible honor. To anyone who's ever loved musical theater before, getting to be in the same room as Stephen Sondheim is something that we can never forget, we can never outdo. It's something that I will certainly hold in my heart for the rest of time. There was just such a beautiful connection in knowing that when he was 24, he wrote these beautiful lyrics that lasted 64 years now. Yeah, and as this is my first professional gig and West Side Story was his, it's just an absolutely wonderful connection to have to someone that I love so dearly, and we miss him so desperately.
That is beautiful. And you know, I was talking to you before we came on and just how much I love this musical and how much we need this musical in our lives in this format. Do you have a favorite song, or did you have a favorite scene when you were making this film?
Oh my goodness. I mean, I didn't expect to enjoy the emotional scenes as much as I did. Obviously, you take the work home with you. Sometimes it's very hard to not, and I used to feel the emotion in my body as this crazy tension for days and days. Performing A Boy Like That and I Have a Love with Ariana DeBose, who plays Anita, she is incredible, and it was such a difficult scene to perform, and we sang the entire thing live over the course of 2 days. And it was just an emotional roller coaster and a marathon that I think we both ended up winning a gold medal for at the end of the day. And also the final scene in the movie is so painfully emotional. It's tragic, and it leaves you wondering what happens to Maria after the credits roll. And that's something that I've always been very interested in. And that letter that she has to send home to her dad explaining what happened in these American streets. It's a beautiful story, and Tony Kushner's script elevates it so much. And getting to play this new, reinvented, she's not the ingenue you remember, and she has a lot more agency, and she's very strong, and it's very important for Latinas to see that on screen.
pretty clear you do as well. We cannot wait to see what comes next. And exactly. Of course, we can't wait to see West Side Story. It's in theaters on December 10th. Thanks for coming in.
Well, hey there, GMA fans. Robin Roberts here. Thanks for checking out our YouTube channel. Lots of great stuff here. So go on, click the subscribe button right over here to get more of awesome videos and content from GMA every day, anytime. We thank you for watching, and we'll see you in the morning on GMA.